So etiopathogenesis of acute gastritis, mainly diet and personal habits. Highly spiced food can cause acute gastritis, excessive alcohol consumption, malnutrition, heavy smoking. Heavy smoking is nothing but the smokers will smoke continuously like chain smokers without having any particular bland diet. Even that will lead to acute gastritis. It is not only smoking the cigarette, any smoke which irritates the gastric mucosa. Infections like bacterial infections, example H. pylori, Helicobacter pylori, diphtheria, salmonellosis, pneumonia, staphylococcal food poisoning can cause acute gastritis. Severe stress, emotional factors like shock, anger, etc., or even extensive burns, trauma, surgery can cause acute gastritis. What they do is they reduce the blood flow, then increases the acid secretion and its accumulation due to H. pylori infection, resulting in damage to epithelial barrier. Decreased production of bicarbonate buffering takes place. Morphological features, grossly when we look at the part, the gastric mucosa is edematous with abundant mucus and hemorrhagic spots. Microscopically, there is a variable amount of edema and infiltration by neutrophils in the lamina propria. In acute hemorrhagic and erosive gastritis, the mucosa is left off and there are hemorrhages on the surface. Now look at into the chronic gastritis. It is a typically less severe but more persistent than the acute gastritis. Nausea and upper abdominal discomfort may occur, sometimes with vomiting, but hematemesis is uncommon. The vomiting of the blood is uncommon in case of chronic gastritis. The main causative agent for chronic gastritis is H. pylori, Helicobacter pylori. Other chronic irritants, including psychologic stress, intake of excess amount of caffeine in the form of coffee drinking, alcohol and tobacco usage. The mechanism of chronic gastric injury by any of the etiologic agent is by cytotoxic effect of the injurious agent on the gastric mucosal epithelium, thus breaking the barrier and then inciting the inflammatory response. This will be classified into different types according to the parts of the stomach based on the type of mucosa affected. They are classified into cardiac, body, pyloric, antral or transitional, a clinico-pathologic classification. Type A gastritis, that is also called as autoimmune gastritis. Mainly the body fundic mucosa is affected. It's one of the autoimmune type, mainly seen in Hashimoto thyroiditis, that is inflammation of the thyroid gland, and Addison's disease. Then antibodies against parietal cells and intrinsic factors, there is a depletion of parietal cells and impaired secretion of intrinsic factor. Gastric atrophy and pernicious anemia can be seen in this condition. Then depletion of gastric acid producing mucosal area, there is a hypo or acloidria. Type B gastritis, that is H. pylori related, Helicobacter pylori related gastritis, mainly seen in the antral mucosa, that is the commonest area for this type B gastritis. It is also called as hypersecretory gastritis due to excessive secretion of acid, commonly due to infection with H. pylori bacteria. Patients may have associated peptic ulcers, means in case of chronic gastritis, there is a chances of patient getting into ulcer. No autoimmune biases can be seen. Type AB gastritis, that is mixed gastritis, also called as environmental gastritis or chronic atrophic gastritis, commonly seen at body, fundic and antral mucosa. This is the most common type of gastritis in all age groups. Mucosal atrophy and metaplasia, means change of the mucosal layer or the cells at the intestinal area. Morphological features, grossly the gastric mucosa may be normal or edematous. Histologically, event of inflammatory changes in the mucosa. Chronic superficial gastritis, that is inflammatory infiltrate consisting of plasma cells and lymphocytes in the superficial layer of the gastric mucosa. But there are no histological changes in the deep layer of mucosa containing gastric glands. H. pylori, a spiral shaped bacteria. Chronic atrophic gastritis, inflammatory cells infiltrate in the deeper layer of the mucosa and atrophy of the epithelial elements including destruction of the glands. Metaplasia are commonly associated with atrophic gastritis. Gastric atrophy, that is thinning of the gastric mucosa with loss of glands but no inflammation. Chronic hypertrophy, mainly gastritis, uncommon, the causes are uncommon. Thickening of gastric rugal folds resembling cerebral convulsions affecting mainly the region of fundic body mucosa. The patients present with dyspepsia, hematemesis, melena or protein lozing enteropathy. Miscellaneous forms of chronic gastritis, that is eosinophilic gastritis, hemorrhagic or erosive gastritis or granulomatous gastritis. Peptic ulcers, these are the other conditions. Once the gastritis is not treated well or the diet is not mentioned properly, that may lead to peptic ulcers. Peptic ulcers are the areas of degeneration and necrosis of gastrointestinal mucosa exposed to acid peptic secretions. Commonly 98 to 99% in either the duodenum or in the stomach in the ratio of 4:1. That is, commonly we get the peptic ulcers in the duodenum area than in the stomach area. Each of the two main types may be acute or chronic. Acute peptic ulcer, also called as acute peptic stress ulcers. These are multiple small mucosal erosions seen most commonly in the stomach but occasionally involving the duodenum. The etiological factors of acute peptic ulcers are psychological stress, physiological stress like shock, severe trauma, septicemia, extensive burns, intracranial lesions, Cushing's ulcers developing from hyperacidity following excessive vagal stimulation, drug intake commonly like aspirin, steroids, indomethacin, local irritants like alcohol, smoking, coffee, etc.